Truck Center Parts of Shea.
Hey, I'm trying to get the price on a clutch brake.
Excuse me?
I'm trying to get the price on a clutch brake.
Okay. What's the last 6 of your VIN?
Z as in Zebra, 31600.
Z31 what?
600.
I'm not understanding you.
600.
Okay. Z31600. You're looking for a clutch brake?
Yeah.
All right, hold on, please.
So everybody's got clutch issues this week. Well, so does Andrew. So does Andrew. But it's only a clutch brake. Showing y'all how I get the prices on this stuff. Oh, by the way, Friday. Today's not Friday. It's Thursday. I'm at the house chilling. Chilling.
Center's parts and service department hours differ at each location and can be found on our website at www.tagtruckcenter.com.
And real quick, my clutch brake is not out. The truck is drivable. It's not my clutch.
We have in stock, they're 2218 each.
Okay, 218?
2218.
$22.18. Oh, okay. Okay, thank you. Damn, clutch brake that cheap? Damn, $22? You know what I thought he said? $2,218. All right, something don't sound right. I look at the receipt and now I paid the Latinos $216, but those were labor too, though. But so $22 for a clutch brake, and find one of the mechanics who want to put it on. I ain't gonna put it on right now because I'm for the book a load. I just looked at the load board. I seen a load, it was like $4,000 to go to West Virginia. They got another load going to North Carolina on the 3rd. No, on the 2nd. I don't think I want to take off the weekend. If I can get the load going to West Virginia and get it back here and deliver it by Sunday, then I can take that load to North Carolina and we can gross $7,000-$8,000 for the week. Not saying that's gonna happen. I gotta see if I can get this load. I don't know if it's still available or not, but hey, that's what I'm doing on this Thursday. Don't forget to check out my YouTube store to see what I be doing. Fuck your money. Gotta love Detroit 379 Blue Pete. A lot of y'all wanna know how much does a truck like that go for? Like I said, if I had to take a guess, knowing the updated information that I got now, that truck ran somewhere between $45,000 and $50,000. So it was very expensive. The reason why I say that is because I looked at the other trucks that got here for sale that was in the same age range. If he had the Detroit 60 Series, he was selling them for $35,000. But the ones with the cat, he was selling between $45,000 to $50,000. So, fuck your money, got the cat. So, I'm going to assume since all the other trucks with the cats in them are going for $45,000 to $50,000, that's about how much someone paid for that truck. Now, who that someone is, I have no idea. But it's a lovely truck. And, you know, he said he got the title and the bill of sale. I just hope that you know, it's his, you know. That's just what I'm hoping for. But now, is the truck worth it? I would take the truck. I don't know if I would have paid that price for it. I would have probably went to the auction, man. I think in the auction, those cat engines, man, them trucks in the auction, I don't think I ever seen them go past $35,000. And, of course, the dealership got to make their money, too, so it's going to always be a upcharge. Maybe they negotiated it down to $40,000 or $35,000. I'm not sure, but the truck is definitely worth what he paid for. I mean, if he got ready to sell it, I don't know if you're gonna get back $45,000 to $50,000 for it. I think you could definitely get $35,000. So it's not really gonna depreciate that much. Especially if it's got the overhaul paperwork to it. But enough of his case. What am I doing? I'm chilling, man. I'm about to, you know, when you're doing this tinker work, you're always at the house. I just took a load. So if y'all watch YouTube stores, I went 4 hours up, 4 hours back. I made my money. You know what I'm saying? I'm done. Done. Done for the week.
Excuse me.
What are you doing?
They're someone's control. They've probably done the same thing.
What did you do?
Yeah.
Done for the week. Or just for the day. Maybe tomorrow. Might go to work tomorrow. Let me see if I can get this little clutch break. $22, see? Now y'all know the real price. Hello?
Is this Justin?
Yes.
Justin, this is Dwayne and Crowe's attorney. Phone call.
Yes.
Call about a clutch break.
Right.
Will you want to know how much it would cost to change it?
Yes.
Well, I mean, it's going to depend. I kind of need to look at it. I mean, I see if the original one's a one piece or a two piece. I mean, if it's a one piece, I got to cut it out. Take more time. If it's a two piece, I can, you know, separate it and replace it, and then, you know, it won't take any time at all. Chances are it's got a one piece in it if it's original clutch. Also, with that being said, hardly ever do you see just a clutch brake go bad. Normally, you've overextended your clutch, and then it's going to be clutch time. But I mean, I'll be more happy to look at it, but I can't really give you a quote on the phone.
Okay.
It's going to depend on what I've got to work with when I get underneath it, you know, to see what we're dealing with.
Oh, do you know how much it would cost to replace the whole clutch?
I mean, does it have a PTO on it?
A PTO. It's got a hydro cam on it.
No, PTO, power takeoff. Has it got a wet kit on it? Hydraulics or anything?
Yeah, I think it's mechanical.
Okay. Normally a clutch job is 10 hours, plus resurfacing the flywheel.
Okay.
And it depends on what clutch you want, if you want to put a reman in it, put a new in it. All that factors in. But, you know, you're looking at, you know, roughly $1,200-$1,400 labor.
Okay.
You know, and that's bidding high. I mean, it may not take me that long.
Okay. Sounds good.
So, but yeah, if you want to bring it up here, man, we'll look at it and see what you got going on.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
You know, now that he say that, overextending my clutch. You know, the clutch brake was working fine. It was working totally fine. And it was working totally fine. I'm talking about just yesterday. And I remember pressing the clutch down to the ground. And all of a sudden, it's like the clutch brake wasn't slowing it down no more. And now every time I put it in gear, I gotta like hold it down to the ground, wait like 5 seconds for the clutch brake to slow it down. So, and this is a new clutch brake too. Keep in mind, I did this clutch brake in the oil field. Has it been a year? I want to say it was exactly 1 year ago, because it's still February. I did it at AAA Diesel about a year ago, around this time. And they cut the clutch brake out, put a new one in. It ain't even got 50,000 miles in that clutch brake, so maybe I do need a clutch. It's a question for SoCal. SoCal got the answers. It's a question for SoCal. Y'all comment below and let me know what y'all think. Do I just need to just go on and replace the clutch? Now, if you ask me, has the clutch ever been replaced? Not that I know of. I know I ain't replaced the clutch. And I got the maintenance records for the truck before I got it. I don't recall clutch work being done whatsoever. So now I do got a manual clutch. I don't recall it having a PTO or anything like that on it. I think it is manual because it don't take any fluids or nothing like that. But 10-hour job. I don't know what they charge. Let's just say $100 an hour, $1,000. He said $1,200 for a label. How much is the parts? I just call a dealership and figure that out. Call the dealership and give them the VIN number. They'll tell you the price. Because I get new parts. I don't really go with the reman. I try to go with new. I go remanufactured if they don't have new parts available. But if they got new parts, I like going with the new parts. But as of right now, the truck is drivable. Ain't nothing wrong with the truck. But as soon as I see issues, I try to get it done immediately, okay? So, and by the way, that's Crows. That's who rebuilt the bottom part of my engine. Obviously, I'm calling it back because I'm satisfied with their work. No engine problems whatsoever. I didn't have none before, and I don't got none after. So, I don't mind them doing the work. Like I said, that's Crows Truck Service, Highway 78, Memphis, Tennessee. And when I figure out, after I talk to SoCal, I'll let y'all know some updated information. Now, we're not going to get this done right this second because I'm still booking work. I'm still working. Like I said, it just happened. I'm just giving y'all the information as I'm noticing, okay?